Welcome to my channel. Welcome to my channel. Hey, welcome to my channel. It's the one and only Kwani, and today I am doing a Sam's Club wig haul. So I got some wigs up in here that I will be unboxing. Are you taking pictures of me? This is the box right here. I hope I didn't cut another wig like this last time. Oh no, I'm good. So, one of the wigs that I will be showing you guys, I'm actually about to put on too in my next video. So, you will see how that looks. Okay, so the first wig I'm showing you guys is the Cher Mousse. It's a lace front wig, and it's called, I think it's called Kenesha, and I have it in LT6131B. So I have the wig that's on the model, and I'm actually wearing this wig in November for my fiance's birthday. And so I just got it early. He actually picked this one out because I had asked him, like, did you like this? Like, what you think of this one? And then they have one, like, with the pink bottom and then a blue bottom. But he chose this so I can also wear it to work. So stay tuned for that in a couple of months because I will be wearing this wig. And it is so pretty. Look at that. Oh, yeah. I can't wait to wear her. So that's wig number one. This next wig, oh, did I get the model color? I think so. So the next wig I got is from Nisha Soft and Natural Lace Front Wig. And this one is in color DRFF Honey Brown. So I believe I got this one. And it is so pretty. And I got these wigs for work because it's kind of hot and I'm tired of wearing like long hair. So I got this one. So I'll be wearing that soon also. Then the next one I have is from Color Bomb. And it's in, and this wig is called Cassidy, I believe. And it's in color 3D RFF Buttery Blonde. So this is what it looked like. So I think I got this one, if I remember correctly, because I just thought that one was so pretty with the blonde and a little darker blonde highlight kind of feel. Yeah. There's a receipt in here. I'll tell you how much each of them cost. And then the next wig, I actually have two. And so I got one in one color and another in a different color. Because I know I told you guys, like, if I really, really like a wig, I buy multiple ones, but I just get different colors. And this is the one that I'm actually going to put on for you guys, like, in a minute. So it's from Beyond Your Imagination. Is that what you guys... Oh, it's a Zuri Sis wig. Because it says sis on top. So I believe it's a Zuri Sis wig. Let me tell you something. I love... This wig right here is a Zuri Sis A-line wig. And I had this wig for years. It's a bob wig. I love Zuri wigs. I love how they do their parts. Like, I need to touch up on here. And their wigs last a long time. And usually I notice with, like, color wigs, they tend to get nappy and stuff faster, but this wig is everything. I had it for a long time, and I actually have another one that I have brought right after I got this one, and it's in burgundy, and I haven't even worn that one yet. So I love me a Zuri Sis wig. So this is the kind I got. So this is the one I'm putting on. I'm like obsessed with it, and this is the exact one I'm putting on. Actually, it's the Sombre RT 2730. So it kind of got like the brown root, and then it's brown, and then it has like, you can't really see all the different tints of brown. Oh no, it's just brown. I thought it was like a little highlight feel because it says 27 and 30. But we see once I take this one off the box. So this is the one I'm about to put on. So I'm going to put it over here. And then this one is in a color one. So I just got one in black also. But I'm going to go ahead and wear that brown one because it's like, you know, super cute and stuff. But once again, it has the moon part. So, you know, it has the part all the way around from there to there. So you can do different styles with it and stuff. So I'm about to put these wigs back in the box and then we're going to install this one. And then I'll show you guys how I do my wigs. So this is what the wig looks like when you first take it out. So it comes with the ponytail and everything already made for you, which is good because now I don't have to worry about trying to do the ponytail because it's already done. So the first thing I do when I do my wigs is, okay, try to fix it. I do the lint. I do the lace part first. Not cutting the lace, but making it match my complexion. So I guess it's called the tinting of the lace. And this is what I use. I get this from my local beauty supply store. And I have it in color Cafe Carmel. And it's from Ruby Kisses. No More Blush Powder. So I use this, and it looks really good. And I also go underneath the wig when I put mine on. I don't put mine on the top part, and it shows, it comes right through. And it looks natural. Oops, got a little powder on there. So you can see, like, I use this up. And I'm gonna tell you guys something like really crazy. I usually use a Q-tip when I do these, so I can just like brush it on. Well, multiple Q-tips, but I ended up finding this brush. So I'm gonna try to use this and see how it do. And then I just go to the part, and I just color it in, as I like to say. Like it to be super dark, and I don't want to see like any parts of the original color of the lace. I want to see all of the powder.
And
Oh, see? Look at that. Oh, I hope I can get through. I'm probably going to end up using the other side because I didn't bring any Q-tips here with me. So, I'm probably going to have to be a little more gentler. But when I wear braided wigs, I would use this to just go over. So let me kind of try it with this. There we go. Yeah, I'm just going to use this. Get this. And another reason why I like using this is because, like I said, it looks really close to my skin complexion. I don't wear makeup, so I know a lot of girls, they put the foundation on and they can blend it really well with their skin because they end up putting their makeup on, and I don't wear it, and you can't even tell that this is a lace front. Well, we can tell, but you know, a lot of people at my job, they think it's like my real hair, or they think like if I have the braided wig, that the braids is my hair, and maybe the back. And so we always ask me, is that your hair? And I'm like, no, this one is a wig. And they were like, what? I'm like, yeah. I have no shame in telling people I wear a wig. I love to see their reaction because they be like, what? And that's the reaction I'm starting to get with my press-on nails too. People think like, they be like, where do you go? I said, oh, I do it myself. I just glue them on. These are press-ons. And they say, those are press-ons? And I'm like, yeah, press-ons and stuff. They cook stuff. I'm all about the press-on game now. Thank you, Corona, because I saved so much money. Let me not say thank you, Corona. That sounds insensitive. But because of Corona, I found another outlet, and I get really cute press-on nails for dirt cheap. Now, once I do the lace, the inside part, I go along the, I guess you could say the perimeter, and I just fill this in too. Normally I would dab it on, but kind of on a time crunch because we have to check out. How much time we have left until we got to check out? We got 30 minutes? At 12. It's 11:09, so yeah. So I got less than an hour. So I'm trying to rush because everything was ready not to plan how I wanted my hair to be. So I'm just gonna finish out my trip with my wig on. Which is cool, because I'm gonna have my nails on too today. Which I'm gonna do next. Okay, so now that that's all done, I just turn it over. Now, you may get some on you here, but don't worry about it. And that's how it looks now. So now I'm about to cut it. Hey, Sai, can you give me a paper towel, please? Desiah, yeah. Give me a paper towel, please. Me a whole towel.
Cause you said towel.
I said paper towel.
Oh, sorry.
It's okay. So there's no baby hairs on this wig. which is cool because I'm still trying to learn how to, still trying to perfect that part. Because I feel like it makes a lot of hairstyles pop, especially how they're making these synthetic wigs now. But I be trying them. Sometimes they do really good, and then sometimes it will look a mess. So, how I cut my wig is I just start right here. Not so much here. I come back to that part. I just start right here. And some people cut it straight across, and then I usually use smaller scissors than this, but I can't find my scissors because they're way easier to cut. And I just go like this when I'm cutting. Just move it like that. So I'll show y'all, but I do try to get as close to the lace as I can, and this lace is actually really easy to cut. That's another thing with Zuri wigs that I like. The lace is not hard at all. Some of these wigs, they lace be hard. That's why I like the other scissors. And I don't have any razors with me. Uh-oh. Kind of messed up the ponytail a little bit. Oh, man. It's alright, though. And then once I get to the end, then I will go ahead and just cut this little part off. Huh? Did you say something to me, Sire?
Oh, no, I just said girls at school.
Oh, they're racing?
Kind of.
Okay. Go here, cut that straight, and then voila, lace is cut, and it looks like this now. Hey, Desiah.
Yeah?
I have another wig cap right here. Can you pass that to me, please? So now I'm going to go in. So I don't use the combs when I do my wigs, but it does have combs in it. So it has a comb here, a comb in the middle, and a comb right here. So it got three combs in the front, and then it has the one comb in the back. And I try not to use this comb in the back either because I hate when it connects to my braiding. Usually it's the straps that connects to my braiding.
Why do they put the things in there?
So people can connect it to the hair so it can stay on. It's like secure it more, but I don't use the combs. I used to, but then I stopped years ago.
Ew.
I'm gonna try it on this one and see how it looks, because I don't want it too loose. Especially since my braids are old. All right. So I'm going to put the wig on. So I already have a wig cap on. But since this wig is old, I already know how it fits, but sometimes I double cap, trying to get it as flat as possible. And this one is a new one. I have this one is old too. And that's another thing I like about the wig. I know, because you don't have to have like the brown cap or anything, because you're not gonna see this black one at all. So another trick that I do is I try to line this up and then make sure the ear to ear part is lined up, because I usually don't use a mirror. I go to the mirror like right before I walk out the door just to make sure everything is good. But I usually just go like this, start in the back, and then bring it to the front. Make sure my size is at my ears and I feel like that's evenly. And once I feel like that's even, I probably can make this wig a little tighter. And this is the wig. I like this wig, just stick it to my lip more. And then just do like this. Oh, actually, this lace has it looking a little darker than my complexion, just a little bit. That's okay. Because it still looks really, really, really good. Even though it's a little, this lace has it looking a little orangey, but that's fine. And the wig is nice and short, how I like it. You like it, Sai?
I love it.
Well, thank you. And I like this color, too.
Looks good on you.
And then this is the ponytail.
That looks beautiful. Are you going to wear that to work?
Oh, yes, sir. I will be wearing it tomorrow. Thank you, man.
You're welcome. Actually, this match your eyes.
Yeah, it does. Got the whole little honey blonde going on, or honey brown. So, yeah. So this is how I do my wig installs. I hope it's helpful, especially because I don't do anything extra complicated and all that other stuff. It's really simple. So like always, thank you for taking the time out of your day to spending a moment out of my day with me. Bye, guys.